None of you remember? But what was the internationalization process? I'm asking about a normal internationalization process for a country which is there in any market and wants to expand globally. You remember I was trying to give you an example. Let's say you want a virtual reality device, or you want a 3D printer, or maybe back you wanted an iPhone. How did you get it? Let's say you couldn't buy a product which is there in US or Europe, and you wanted it over here. How did you get it? You remember that conversation that we had in one of our earlier classes? So initially it would be unsolicited exports. Does anyone remember? So this is what I was, why do I always remind you of Confucius's proverb? You listen, you'll forget. None of you remember? Unsolicited exports. That means the company would not be giving up, paying a lot of heed. It's in like Russian phase. There's a lot of demand in their own market, their capacity is restricted. Am I saying something totally new? Then maybe in their own market, demand gets saturated and the demand in international market increases. Then what will happen? I was trying to tell you that maybe a smart entrepreneur from either Linking Road or Guffer Market will take up an agency, will import the products and start selling. None of you remember. Then, maybe with some passage of time, more demand is generated. Then what will happen? They will open up a sales office. Does anyone remember? I did it, I must have shown a slide and discussed, if you remember. A class where we were discussing about the entry strategies of companies from, I don't know, remember. From underdeveloped markets, I was trying to tell you how can companies go from underdeveloped markets to international markets. We were discussing about higher electronics, for example, I've given. Why is the road? Nowhere. What? Nowhere. Okay. So I'm trying to tell you what is the normal route of internationalization for a company which is operating from an international market, from a developed market, because maybe of their brand name, they will not have a lot of difficulty in selling their products. Because let's say you want now an Apple product, maybe they are going to come out with Apple TV or maybe some new generation product. So you don't have to think twice, because institutional wallet for the business in the past. And in that class only, I must have said that if a company is going from an underdeveloped market to a developed market, can they follow the same route? I was trying to tell you about higher electronics, how it went about Lenovo.
Yes. Lenovo acquired IBM in US.
Tata acquired Tata Tetley. I remember having discussions.
Yes.
Tata acquiring Jaguar. Higher participating in some blind tests. None of you remember? They came out with a small compact refrigerator. That's it. Well, I must have spoken fast and you have. Okay, whatever it is. So now you think of this company which has been operating since 60, 70 years. What kind of products is it selling? And they have exited some of their business. Okay. So, medical products and diagnostic products. So, these are the two kind of products that they are currently manufacturing, or maybe were manufacturing,
and have decided to focus on
one of them rather than getting into other businesses. After they have decided, usually, let's say, Where do you think? Have you ever visited a rig office? Huh? You visited? You've seen the equipments? Which companies' equipments are there? Siemens. So where are these companies based out of? US, Germany. So similarly, Becton Dickinson is also a company on those lines. Why is it that don't we have any Indian manufacturer? So people have, you see, these companies like Becton Dickinson, their products would have also been in demand in other markets. So most probably in 40s or 50s, they would have started with their path of internationalization. And how would they have gone about it? Initially maybe, whatever products they had, they were catering to the local market. Someone now sitting in India or Nepal or Burma or one of the Latin American countries or African countries, if they would have wanted some of their diagnostic equipment, what would they have done? What would they have done? They would have maybe traveled. The same internationalization process. The company might not have been taking any steps to push sale, but maybe they felt they have seen in some offices. This is the process of internationalization usually followed by companies from different regions to other markets. Yes or no? Huh? All of you agree? So you will have some unsolicited exports to start with. Unsolicited means the company is not taking any steps, but then someone or the other will be coming. There may be a smart entrepreneur from that region might take an import-export license and start importing the product. Now, in that particular market where the host country is operating, maybe demand would have stagnated, production capacity would have been added. Now they want more sales. So they will set up a sales subsidiary. That means they go and ask few of their managers to go and open up a office somewhere and take care of direct sales. More demand comes, they will maybe acquire some small factories or companies and integrate them with them. Or maybe even there is huge further more demand. What will happen? Then maybe they will think, like what is Samsung doing right now? It's trying to open up a factory in India. 120 million.
Already opened.
Already opened. So 120 million capacity. Why? From South Korea, why is it opening up a factory over here? Right now. And why did it have to wait for so long? It could have done that 20 years back or 15 years back.
So it could be their demand.
This is kind of past. Initially maybe Samsung would not have given a lot of attention to the Indian market. But with passage of time, any company if you see. So do you think, okay, it's okay, not only labor cost but transportation tariff. You have been playing the game. How much does it cost you to transfer, even if you are manufacturing in one location and you have to transfer it to another geography? What are the other costs apart from labor? Import duty, transportation cost, there is a time lag. Maybe the product has to be localized as well. So this, usually how much time do you think from here to here, how much time do you think it takes? Yes, yes. When do you think the factories were there in Russia?
Not Russia.
Japan, Brazil, Mexico. Where do they have their factories? Europe, Mexico, Brazil, and Japan. So four regions. So do you think the factories would have suddenly come up overnight? So if you go by this logic, maybe the internationalization, you see, for this company, might have started in 40s and 50s. Because you suddenly don't go and open up a factory in another country, isn't it? Unless and until there is huge demand. Greenfield means you don't go in with any partner, you invest all the money up front, set up a factory over there. Some acquisitions will be there, some greenfield investments will be there, depending on the size of the market. Greenfield means you are investing all your money or on your own. Huh? Everything is on your own. No partners, no JVs, nothing. Are you following me? So, why do you think now? So, coming back to the question about Ray Gilmer. Ray? What is his name? Ray Gilmer. What do you think? He was a smart person or he was a fool?
He was a smart.
Smart? Why? Why do you think he was a smart person? Huh? What else is there in the case which says that he was a smart person?
Sir, he introduced a sophisticated planning system to exert tighter control.
So he had also introduced this process of planning. 20 years he was there with this company also?
Yes, sir.
So if you would have been a fool 20 years, you would not have lasted. Where did he go?
Merck.
So Merck, a much bigger company as a CEO. So this very clearly shows that he was not a fool. So then the process that he had initiated and implemented, what was the challenge in the process that this new CEO is finding there? And do you agree with that? So you should change, what is it that the PS wants you to do first? First understand that. First tell me what do you think are the problems. What was the need for the planning process to start with? Why do you think Ray Gilmer would have started this process? Acquisition means you don't, or JV. Let's say now there is a company over here which is manufacturing maybe chemicals, and Dow is thinking of entering maybe Dow Chemical is thinking of entering this market. So if it has to buy land, take all the provisions, set up the factory, it might take him 2-3 years, but if he feels that there is existing infrastructure in place, so why not acquire it and save both the time and money? You can negotiate or maybe have a JV with them after some work. So what is their condition? Maybe an answer to the
question.
The JV, that's why I wrote JV. What is JV? JV is? JV is joint venture. So let's say Starbucks has now entered. So JV with? So where was I? So my question, what I was trying to understand, maybe make you understand, is why do you think Ray Gilmer started this process in the first place? What was the need? So he was a control freak? So why has the strategy to be changed now? What is the new Yes. So why do you need planning? So this is, you see, this is strategic planning. This is the class that we are having right now is to introduce you to the concept of strategic planning. And here maybe you feel that there's been a planning process which is there, which was maybe implemented by the erstwhile CEOs of 20 years back. And the new CEO who has come wants to change the way the company is planning for the future. And maybe they have highlighted certain challenges. So your task ideally is to design a new planning process. So first, what I'm trying to understand is, what was the need for this planning process? Okay, let me take a pause and ask you a few things. These are the two kinds of products that this company is selling. If I ask you a question, please can you tell me what kind of strategy do you think this company is adopting for these two kinds of products? Let me see how much you have understood strategy till now. My question is very simple. Ideally, let's say, yes, what are you, tell me. My question is, what does it require any reading of the case? You have two different product categories. Ideally, what kind of strategy do you think a company would have been approaching or thinking of adopting for this kind of products? Why? Think. And which products do you think would be there in the international markets? Yes? Those who are, so many of you have written your roll numbers. You have read 42, 24, 25. Where are three of you? Yes, yes. What do you think? Why? What are the medical products? Can you give me some examples? So, have you seen the medical products sometime in your life? Scissors, scalpels, maybe? What are they?
Surgical
gloves, maybe. So what do you think? What is the complexity of the product?
So, this is the time when glass products
have been changing to
passive products.
They could have sold it. No, you first try and understand the basic attributes of this product. And let's try and spend some time in that. So let's say scissors, scalpels, gloves, urine collectors, or whatever.
And all the surgical instruments.
Surgical instruments. What do you think is the complexity of this product? Tell me the complexity of the product. Complexity of the product. So you all said you have all been to hospitals. How many G's, scissors have you seen? Have you seen? Gloves of G, why not? You've seen? So what kind of, do you think these products are very complex?
Yes.
Products is complex?
Highly standardized.
When can you standardize a product? You're not getting my question. My question, what I'm trying to understand from you is, try and think of the industry where all the companies which are manufacturing medical products. Is there a lot of difference? Do you think you'll find a lot of differences between the products offered by different companies?
No.
Will you find lot of difference. A lot of time. So they are kind of, maybe you can say, commodity products, which are very standard products.
So this is what I say, this was the time
when
they were using glass products and
switching to plastic. It's okay. So the industry, everyone would have changed. From glass or whatever. So it's a change in industry. But my question is, all competitors have also been taking. Can you take these products international? Is it very difficult for a local manufacturer? Is it very difficult for a local manufacturer to replicate whatever technology is there in the industry and come up with its own product? Precision, scissor, scalpel, knife. What is the precision required there? Is it a very complex product? Let's say, is it as complex as maybe those MRI machines? What I'm trying to understand from you is the complexity of the product, and if the product is less complex, do you think there will be few players or many players? I am now in medical products only. I have not come to the second one. I am right now in one product category. Are you getting me? I am not for medical products. I am trying to understand the complexity of the product. And I believe all of you agree that these products are not that complex. So what kind of strategies do you think company would be usually adopting? Differentiation, you can't now differentiate the scissors alone. So it has to be a low cost strategy, ideally. What is required to adopt a low cost strategy? Maybe economies of scale, having close access to the markets where you are selling. All those things are what you have read. So will a company be profitable by exporting these products, or can be competitive by exporting these products? All of you agree to that or not? That is clear. Now let's come to them. Maybe there might be one or two of the medical products. Like maybe this. What is the written page? Diabetic scare products or even there maybe the complexity, maybe one or two of the products of medical products might be a little bit more complex. Now let's come to the diagnostic products. What do you think about the complexity?
It's very complex.
So they will be relatively much more complex than the medical products.
Also much more delicate to be
transferred. Okay, maybe delicate or expensive. Even like when some of you said that you have seen GE's equipment, why is it that Indian companies have not been able to manufacture those products? Why we still, even if you want it, you export it or import it from maybe US or Germany or wherever they are manufactured?
Complex,
patent. Not maybe shared. Technology.
Yes.
So all of you are. So complex products. So very complex, maybe research and design and lot of advanced technology. Now, what kind of strategy do you think companies will be adopting in when they are selling those kind of products? Product differentiation. Very clearly. So they will not. There is a premium. They can charge whatever price they want. Now you tell me, with the internationalization maybe in 50s or 60s or whenever it would have happened, which products maybe would have been, they would have taken international?
Diagnostic
products. So let's say, where do you have your factories?
Japan.
So you have your factories in USA, US, you don't have factories? How many worldwide teams are there? And how many SBUs were there?
17 worldwide teams.
17 worldwide teams and?
31
businesses. 31 SBUs. So what was a worldwide team and what was the role of a worldwide team? So you all are saying how many WWE teams are there? 17. 17. So what is an SBU? So what is that? Where is it? And what is it doing? What do you think it is doing? No, my question is, look at this case. I want to understand what is the strategic business
here. Sir, they are the cooperative leaders who are taking the decisions from the lower level, from the key processes, and they are taking the decision to make the business strategy, means to plan the strategy ahead.
In one of our earlier classes again, I think we had discussed between corporate strategy and
business strategy.
So what is the strategic business unit and what was the corporate strategy? What do you think is an SBU here now? And what are these worldwide teams? So these might be, where do you think are the country managers and what is their work? Who are the country managers now? So who is the country manager? Where is he? That's another one I will write somewhere. What is an SBU?
Sir, the country managers are the part of the team.
Yes, Miss Bootcamp. You are on WhatsApp? No? Tell me. What are these SBUs? So these SBUs are? They are maybe? Offices in different regions or countries where the country managers would be heading these SBUs, where the primary responsibility would be what? Mostly, if there is a factory, they would also be looking after. So mostly sales and production and marketing as well. Some of the SBUs might be in Mexico, one of them in Brazil, one of them in some of the smaller countries of Europe, or maybe in Middle East, one might be in India, okay? Are you all following me? So SBUs are those independent business units or those strategic business units which would be responsible for their own PL, would be trying to sell either the products which are sent to them from US or from the other markets or maybe manufactured by themselves, okay? Then what is this worldwide team? What was their need? So what why were the worldwide teams introduced? What was their role?
So we would like to achieve